वेलकम बैक टू फिनिक्स इंग्लिश क्लासेस। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विद द थर्ड एंड फाइनल पार्ट ऑफ चैप्टर 2 लॉस्ट स्प्रिंग विच इज डिस्क्राइब्ड इन फ्लेमिंगो CBSE बोर्ड क्लास 12th। द चैप्टर इज रिटन बाई अनीश जंग। फॉर द बेटर अंडरस्टैंडिंग ऑफ दिस फाइनल पार्ट इट इज़ एडवाइज्ड टू यू इफ़ यू हैव नॉट वॉच्ड its first and second part, please open the description. There is link of both first and second parts, and then start with this third part. Savita, a young girl. Their eyes are more adjusted to the dark than to the light outside. That is why they often end up losing their eyesight before they become adults. Savita, a young girl in a drab pink dress, sits alongside an elderly woman, soldering pieces of glass. As her hands move mechanically, like the tongs of a machine, I wonder if she knows the sanctity of the bangles she helps make. Here in this part of the story, Anish Jung says that these boys and girls who are of very tender age, they start losing their eyesight even before they become adults. Before reaching the maturity, they very often start losing their eyesight. It is so because they are habitual, they are used to do hard work in the dark room, continuously sitting there beside the hearth. And in that dark, their eyes are so much adjusted in the dim light that they start fearing the broad daylight. And as a result of it, they lose their eyesight at a very tender age. There, Anish Jung notices a girl who is sitting beside an elderly woman, an old woman, and she is also working with that woman. She is soldering the pieces of glass, she is also making bangles, and she is so much adapted into the trade that the writer becomes astonished to see her hands move almost mechanically. She does not make any effort for doing it. She does it all automatically. It seems that her hands are the mechanical, robotic hands. But the writer thinks, although she is doing so hard a work of making bangles, perhaps she is unaware of the fact that what she makes as bangles are really a very pious thing. She is helping in such a work which produces the thing which is thought to be very sacred in Indian society. सविता, एक युवा लड़की। उन बच्चों की आंखें बाहर के उजाले की अपेक्षा अंधेरे की ज़्यादा अभ्यस्त हो जाती हैं। शायद यही वजह है कि वे अक्सर वयस्क होने से पहले अपनी आंखों की रोशनी खोने लगते हैं। सविता बादामी गुलाबी रंग की ड्रेस पहने एक युवा लड़की है जो एक बूढ़ी महिला के पास कांच के टुकड़ों को जोड़ते हुए बैठी है। जैसे उसके आंख मशीनी चिमटे वाले अंदाज में चलते हैं, मैं सोचती हूँ कि क्या वो उन चूड़ियों की पवित्रता को जानती है जिन्हें बनाने में वो मदद कर रही है। टू जेनरेशंस। इट सिंबलाइजेज एन इंडियन वुमेन सुहाग ऑस्पिशियसनेस इन मैरिज। इट विल डॉन ऑन हर सडनली one day when Her head is drabbed with a red veil, her hands dyed red with henna, and red bangles rolled onto her wrists. She will then become a bride, like the old woman beside her, who became one many years ago. She still has bangles on her wrist, but no light in her eyes. Here there is a description of two generations who are sitting side by side. One is Savita, who is the young generation, and the other is the old woman beside whom she is sitting. She says that the bangles they are making, they are the symbol of the Indian woman's suhag. It symbolizes suhag, and it is very pious, and it is a thing that is auspicious in marriage. Although this girl Savita does not know anything about its auspiciousness or about its piousness, but soon she will come to know about it all of a sudden one day, because she is of the age when soon she is to be married to someone, and at the time of her marriage, as soon as there is veil on her face, her hands will be dyed in red with henna, and she will have these red bangles rolling on her wrist. She will become a bride, very much like the old woman who is sitting beside her, although it is a long time ago when she was a bride. The situation is still the same. There are bangles on her wrist, but the light in her eyes that would twinkling at the time when she became a bride has been lost. She is almost sand blind, and she is sitting still doing the same job as she was doing in her old childhood and young age. दो पीढ़ियाँ अचानक ही एक दिन ये सत्य उसे पता चल जाएगा, जब उसका सिर लाल घूंघट से ढका होगा, हाथों में मेहंदी की लाली होगी और लाल चूड़ियाँ उसकी कलाइयों पर होंगी या उसकी कलाइयों पर चढ़ाई जाएंगी, तब वो एक दुल्हन के रूप में होगी, उसी बूढ़ी महिला की तरह जो बहुत वर्षों पहले इसी की तरह दुल्हन बनी थी। उसकी कलाइयों में अभी भी चूड़ियाँ तो हैं, लेकिन अब आँखों में वो रोशनी नहीं बची। अ रूफ ओवरहेड। एक वक्त शेर भर खाना भी नहीं खाया, शी सेज इन अ वॉइस ड्रेन्ड ऑफ जॉय। शी हैज़ नॉट एन्जॉयड इवन वन फुल मील इन हर एंटायर लाइफ टाइम। दैट्स व्हाट शी हैज़ रीप्ड। Her husband, an old man with a flowing beard, says, I know nothing except bangles. All I have done is make a house for the family to live in. Hearing him, one wonders if he has achieved what many have failed in their lifetime. He has a roof over his head. Here, there is a small conversation with the old lady and her husband and with the writer. The old lady tells the writer that they have lived a life of misery. She could not recall even one day when she would have a full meal, a square meal. During her entire lifetime, she could not remember any of the days on which she could say she had a square meal. This was the outcome of her work. When the writer asked her husband, the old man, he is a man of flowing beards, he says that he knows nothing. what he has known, what he has done is to make bangles. But he is proud of himself also, that doing this meager wages work, what he has done was tremendous, because he has made a house for the family and they can live in their own house. Anish Jung thinks, on hearing such a thing, if he had really done so great a work, it is his achievement that he has built a house. Even a humble house, even a hut to own by such a bangle maker was no less than a wonder. But she accepts that we cannot deny whatever the old man had done during his lifetime, but at least he had a roof over his head, over his family. सिर के ऊपर एक छत, एक वक्त शेर भर खाना भी नहीं खाया, वो बूढ़ी औरत आनंद रहित आवाज में कहती है। उसने अपने पूरे जीवन एक वक्त का भी भरपेट भोजन नहीं किया, यही कमाई है उसकी। उसका पति लहराती दाढ़ी वाला एक बूढ़ा आदमी कहता है, मुझे चूड़ियों के सिवा कुछ नहीं पता, मैंने जो कुछ भी किया वो ये कि परिवार के रहने के लिए घर बना दिया। उसकी बात सुनकर हैरानी होती है कि क्या उसने वह अर्जित कर लिया है जो बहुत सारे लोग पूरे जीवन नहीं कर पाते। उसके सिर पे छत तो है, नो ड्रीम। द क्राई ऑफ नॉट हैविंग मनी टू डू एनीथिंग एक्सेप्ट carry on the business of making bangles, not even enough to eat, rings in every home. The young men echo the lament of their elders. Little has moved with time, it seems, in Firozabad. Years of mind-numbing toil have killed all initiative and the ability to dream. The writer says that it is not the story of one house only. It is the story of each and every family that lived in those slums of Firozabad. There was the similar cry that they had no money and they had no other alternative except of carrying on with the business they were doing, that was bangle making. It was a really unbelievable to think of any job, any work, except of such kind of a business of making bangles, because every business starts with money and they did not have enough to eat, and that was the story of every house. There were young men, they were also doing the same thing, they had the same reply, they had the same kind of lament as their elders had. It seems that time rolls on everywhere, but it does not roll on in Firozabad, or it may be that the time rolls on here also, but it brings no change as it brings to other places. The people who live here as bangle makers, they work hard. Their hard work is mind-numbing. And it is so tedious, it is so full of toil, that it kills all the initiative, all the courage to start anything that is new. Even they cannot think of dreaming anything else or anything apart from making bangles. All these imagination, these courage have been vanished or have been killed by such a toil as they were doing from generations. कोई सपना नहीं। पैसे के अभाव में चूड़ी बनाने को छोड़कर कुछ और ना कर सकने का रोना हर घर में गूंजता है। इन घरों में भोजन तक के लिए पैसा नहीं है। बूढ़ों की तरह ही नवयुवक भी यही दुख जताते हैं। ऐसा लगता है कि समय बीतने के साथ फिरोजाबाद में कुछ भी नहीं बदला। वर्षों से दिमाग को सुन्न कर देने वाले परिश्रम ने पहल करने या नई शुरुआत करने और सपने देखने की क्षमता का ही कत्ल कर दिया है। क्रूअल मशीनरी और सिस्टम। व्हाई नॉट ऑर्गेनाइज योर सेल्स इंटू अ कोऑपरेटिव, आई आस्क अ ग्रुप ऑफ यंग मैन हु हैव फॉलन इंटू द वाइसियस सर्किल ऑफ मिडिल मैन हु ट्रैप्ड दियर फादर्स एंड फोर फादर्स। Even if we get organized, we are the ones who will be hauled up by the police, beaten and dragged to jail for doing something illegal, they say. There is no leader among them, no one who could help them see things differently. Anish Jung talks to some young people who are gathering there, and she gives a suggestion. As every thinker, every writer has many suggestions, she had also suggestions, and she suggests the group of young men to organize themselves into cooperative so that the government may also help them and they could start their own business. But when she asked this question to the young men, she comes to know that they were also the victim of the same vicious circle of the middlemen who had already trapped their fathers and forefathers. They could not go beyond them. And even if they summon their courage and they become organized and they try to start some new things, some new venture, they knew that the first thing that they would suffer was they would be dragged to the police station, they would be beaten, and ultimately with some false charges they would be sent to the jail, and it would be proved that they were doing something that was illegal. That was the answer she got from the group of the young men. And she concludes the thing that because there was no leader among them and there was no one like a visionary who could show them some new things or who could at least make them able to see the things differently, and they should think of coming out of such a vicious circle as was made all around them. आप खुद को संगठित करके कोऑपरेटिव क्यों नहीं बनाते? मैं नवयुवकों के एक समूह से पूछती हूँ जो दलालों के कभी न निकल पाने वाले चंगुल में फंस गए हैं। ये वही दलाल हैं जिनके चंगुल में उनके माता पिता और परदादे तक फंसे हुए थे। वे नवयुवक कहते हैं कि अगर हम संगठित हो भी जाएं, तो पुलिस हमें ही कुछ अवैध करने के आरोप में घसीटेगी, पीटेगी और जेल में भी डाल देगी। उनके बीच कोई नेता नहीं, कोई ऐसा नहीं जो उन्हें चीज़ों को अलग तरह से देखने में मदद करे। अ क्रूअल साइकिल। डियर फादर्स आर एज टायर्ड एज दे आर, दे टॉक एंडलेसली इन अ स्पाइरल दैट मूव्स फ्रॉम पावर्टी टू एपैथी टू ग्रीड एंड टू इनजस्टिस। Listening to them, I see two distinct worlds. One of the family caught in a web of poverty, burdened by the stigma of caste in which they are born. The other, a vicious circle of the sahukars, the middlemen, the policemen, द कीपर्स ऑफ लॉ, द ब्यूरोक्रेट्स एंड द पॉलिटिशियंस. हियर अनदर रिविलेशन कम्स. शी कम्स टू नो दैट इट इज नॉट दीज यंग मैन बट देयर फादर्स ऑल्सो. दे ऑल सीम टायर्ड, द यंग, द ओल्ड, द ग्रोन अप्स, द चिल्ड्रन, ऑल आर टायर्ड अलाइक. एंड इफ यू स्टार्ट टॉकिंग विद देम, दे विल टॉक एंडलेसली. एंड दिस एंडलेस टॉक विल मेक योर हेड स्पिनिंग इन अ सर्किल दैट स्टार्ट्स फ्रॉम देयर पॉवर्टी, देयर एपैथी, देयर इज ग्रीड ऑल्सो ऑफ द मैन हु एक्सप्लॉइट देम, एंड इनजस्टिस एट एवरी स्टेप दैट दे आर बाउंड टू सफर. इफ यू लिसन टू देम, यू विल कम टू नो दैट देयर वर टू वर्ल्ड्स. One world in which these poor, these deprived, these exploited people live with their family, and they were caught in a perpetual web of poverty. They thought that they are doomed to do all these things because they were born in such a caste in which no other business was possible except of suffering, of making these bangles. And the other world was also a vicious circle that was completed in different levels of the exploiters. There were sahukars, the middlemen, the policemen, the keepers of law, the bureaucrats and the politicians. They made another circle in which they were caught and they were doomed to be crushed until they were alive. एक क्रूर कुचक्र. उनके पिता भी उतने ही थके हैं जितने कि वे स्वयं. वे कभी न खत्म होने वाले एक चक्कर में बात करते हैं जो उनकी गरीबी से, उनकी लाचारी, लालच और अन्याय तक चलता रहता. उनकी बातें सुनते हुए मुझे दो अलग अलग संसार नज़र आते हैं. एक उन परिवारों का संसार जो एक जातिगत कलंक जिसमें वो पैदा हुए हैं उससे बोझल गरीबी के जाल में फंसा है, तो दूसरा साहूकारों, दलालों, पुलिस वालों, कानून के रखवालों, अफसरों और राजनीतिज्ञों का भ्रष्ट तंत्र वाला संसार है जो उनका भरपूर शोषण करता है. Flicker of hope. Together they have imposed the baggage on the child that he cannot put down. Before he is aware, he accepts it as naturally as his father. To do anything else would mean to dare, and daring is not part of his growing up. When I sense a flash of it in Mukesh, I am cheered. I want to be a motor mechanic, he repeats. He will go to a garage and learn. But the garage is a long way from his home. Here we come to know about the transfer of such kind of a burden which is imposed on these little children by the two different worlds which the writer sees. And this burden, this baggage of responsibility and exploitation is put on the shoulders of a child in such a way that he cannot put it down, and before he becomes aware of the fact what he was doing, he starts accepting as naturally as his father, his forefathers have done. And except of doing all these things for being exploited, they do not have anything in their hands, because thinking anything else apart from what they have been conditioned in since their childhood. That means dare. And daring is not a part of their growing up. But when the writer comes to know about the flicker of hope in Mukesh, when he says he wants to become a motor mechanic, it makes the writer happy. She becomes very glad because she knows if there is the flicker of hope, there will be some change in the future of at least those children who can dare to start new things. At that very point, Mukesh once again repeats his own words. He says, "I want to become a motor mechanic." And for becoming a motor mechanic, he has to go to a garage and learn how to repair a car. But the problem was still there. The garage was a long way from his home. आशा की टिमटिमाहट इन दोनों संसार ने, जिसके बारे में यहाँ पर अनीश जंग बात कर रही, इन दोनों संसारों ने मिलकर सारा बोझ उस बच्चे के ऊपर थोप दिया है इस तरह से कि उसे वो उतार नहीं सकता। इससे पहले कि बच्चा इसके बारे में समझ पाए कि ये बोझ कैसा उसके सिर पे, उसके कंधों पे आ पड़ा है, वो अपने पिता की तरह ही इस बोझ को स्वीकार करना शुरू कर देता स्वाभाविक रूप से, क्योंकि कुछ भी नया करने का अर्थ होता है साहस करना, और साहस करना इन बच्चों के लालन पालन का हिस्सा नहीं है। जब मुझको इसकी उपस्थिति का एहसास मुकेश में होता है तो मैं खुश होती हूँ, मैं मोटर मैकेनिक बनना चाहता हूँ, वो फिर से दोहराता है। वो गैराज जाएगा और सीखेगा, लेकिन गैराज उसके घर से काफ़ी दूर है। A determination. I will walk, he insists. Do you also dream of flying a plane? He is suddenly silent. No, he says, staring at the ground. In his small murmur, there is an embarrassment that has not yet turned into regret. He is content to dream of cars that he sees hurtling down the streets of his town. Few airplanes fly over Firozabad. When Anish Jung tries to tell him what were the difficulties that he might have overcome because it was far away from his house, from his home, she tries to discourage him. She wants to try the mettle of the child. The child insists that he will go, even if he had to go on foot. He will walk to the garage. Then Anish Jung tries another question. She says, "Do you also dream of flying a plane?" On hearing this question, the boy becomes silent for a moment. Then he makes a reply, but this time he was not looking eye into eye. He was looking at the ground and he says, "No." This time his voice was not so clear. He was speaking in a murmur. But it was a thing of satisfaction for the writer, because in that small murmur, she could easily hear that there was embarrassment, no doubt, but this embarrassment had not yet turned into regret. It means the hope, the determination of the boy was still alive, and he might show the courage that was really needed there to break that cycle, to break that vicious cycle which had caught them from ages, from generations. Here Anish Jung becomes sure that this boy is not living in imagination only. As soon as he says no, she can easily understand that the boy was on the solid grounds of reality and he was dreaming only about the cars because he knows it was within his reach and cars were the thing that were not only imagination. He saw them every day, every hour, hurtling down the streets of his own town, that is Firozabad. But on the question that the writer herself had made, she gives an explanation. The boy would have said yes. He did not say so only because there are few airplanes that fly over Firozabad. दृढ़ निश्चय, वो अड़ जाता है, मैं चल कर जाऊँगा। क्या तुम हवाई जहाज़ उड़ाने का सपना भी देखते हो? अचानक चुप हो जाता। नहीं, वो ज़मीन की ओर निगाहें जमा के कहता। उसकी बुदबुदाहट में एक निराशा है जो भी पछतावे में नहीं बदली है। वो कारों के सपने से ही संतुष्ट है जो कि वह अपने शहर की सड़कों पर दौड़ते हुए देखता है। फिरोजाबाद के ऊपर से हवाई जहाज कम ही उड़ते हैं। Here ends this chapter, and after completing this chapter, I would like to advise you a few points. If you want to know the meaning of the difficult words, you can read the description. The description box is just below this video. And there is a link also, you can touch it, you can click it to get textbook question and answers. It will redirect to you to the website on which I have put the textbook questions and answers. That will be very useful for board examination also. And for any doubt about the text explanation and the voiceover or the outline of the story, if you have any doubt, you can write to me using this comment section, which is also under that description box. And one thing that I always advise, keep enjoying English literature. We are always with you to make study easier than ever.